Why am I about to do this?
Well, we're off to a cracking start, and you're doing that again. That I can go for. Thank you.
You know, I don't think having two of these is really all too fucking worthwhile. Oh my god, almost just threw myself right into the fucking fire of the blade. And I just got greedy. Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, I don't think having two is actually going to help me, because it takes longer, and that fucking attack with it just... The attack doesn't get me, but the blade just hovers around me, and then I get fucking char-grilled, and the next thing you know, I'm losing health because a weapon is standing near me. It's like Looking Glass fucking Knight with his shield just being by his side, blocking everything deflecting at the speed of fuck off. Pretty much it, exactly. And that was the best thing since sliced bread. Thank fuck you oh, what am I doing? Well, I'm dead. That was... Why the fuck would you heal in front of him? Why? Yeah, okay. I think the biggest battle is going to be with my brain trying to get it to fucking work. I don't even know why I'm doing this to myself. I don't even know. Oh, oh. That missed. So grateful. So grateful. That missed, by the way. I'm so sick of missing with these attacks. Like, I am... If my character model is making contact with your character model, how in the blue fucking dick and shit does my weapon not make contact with you? It makes no sense. If my arms and legs, which are holding the weapon, can touch your fucking leg, why doesn't the weapon that I'm swinging at it hit it? And why are we ballroom dancing again? Like, what the fuck? You have a romantic side. It's like Veldstadt made you long for a lost lover. And you think you found it in me, so we keep having a romantic moment, staring into each other's eyes. Although I'm staring more at your Jap's eye, given the fucking height differentiation. I have one Estus flask, and no health equipped. So I need you to not do what you just did. That's it, beautiful. You really... Okay, no, 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 no. And no, the red... Oh, what the... Fuck. Duck on a fuck, I don't even... Oh, God. I think death was inevitable in this. That's not why I'm pissed off. I'm pissed off because I literally just rolled into it. If I had stood still, I would have lived. My controller could have died. My arms could have lost feeling. And I would have lived.
Well, all my progress with you was reset. I feel like I just new game plused myself. It's going to be harder because of my own impatience with your amount of health. Well, what a great way to open the second attempt, losing nearly all of your health and wasting two Estus flasks immediately. Brilliant. It's like, this is a how not to. This is a how not to live life and fight bosses. Okay, fantastic. I had no stamina and couldn't move. Lovely, I'm just gonna walk away. You seem to be ballroom dancing. That was a mistake! Oh god, I just literally got hit by that. Okay, and this I'm so... Yep, I was out of stamina. You see, when you do that attack when I'm attacking you, I can't get out of the way of everything. And that's clever. But I don't want the boss to be clever. I want the boss to have patterns I can fucking deal with. Not ones that I can't. I just stood there. The smoke and mist of that hits me and I died. I just got 7 hits on you. I just got 7 hits and your health was reduced that little. That's what you call a heartwarming experience. Although, if you want to be more realistic with a heartwarming experience, it's probably sticking that fucking blade in my chest and turning it on. You know what's annoying about this boss? Do you hear that? Let's just do that again. Hang on. Come on, dude. There you go. Listen. The damage is well done. The damage is barely even broadcasted. It doesn't sound like I'm making contact with the blade that went through my arse. Oh my god. At least it's not fun. Okay, my luck appears to be running out all of a sudden, so let's be the lucky ladle handmaiden and go for gold, as I do little to no damage. It's literally the same as two-handing one of them. Oh no, no! Why do you have to have that delayed attack? You deserve. I just got killed by your weapon not moving. I just got killed by the fire being turned on. I got too close to the fireplace and killed myself. I felt like I'm playing The Sims. Brilliant! I honestly don't know why I'm doing this to myself. There was no reason for it. The new DLC is coming out soon. Could have just waited for those bosses to fuck me. Really could have done.
But no, I just randomly woke up this morning. You know what? Let's do the ladle challenge for that boss that's the hardest thing in fucking life itself.
You are harder than evading taxes, for fuck's sake.
You have everything. You have everything that you need. Everything at your disposal.
To make my life miserable. Oh, I've no stamina.
Oh, actually, I don't actually, despite the fact I rolled fucking through it, it still fucking got me.
Yay. How you doing?
Holy shit, that just happened again.
That happened 2 times in a row. Wow.
That's great.
That's great.
Wow. I hit you all those times. And your health is fucking mahoosive!
You can one-hit me with that.
I wasted all my stamina trying to kill you because I'm greedy. But the lesson learned is that can one-hit me currently. Holy shit. No! I know,
If we could just learn to roll to the right of that fucking attack, I think I would have less migraines right now.
Oh my!
I hate you. I hate you so... I hate me. I hate me, I hate me, I hate me, actually.
Your health was possibly the lowest it's been, and it wasn't even remotely low, so...
I'm having so much fun. Hopefully this gives me the fire resistance that I need to survive more of your bullshit. There's a big old asterisk next to that, hopefully, because I don't actually believe it myself. Didn't actually get anywhere close to what I was trying to do with the roll timing. But hey, we got a first-hand impression of how much fire resistance we got from the shield. And here comes a thrust. And not Chris Pontius thrust, you know, the weapon going through a person and fucking skewering him thrust. I got greedy. Great. Greed, the magical tool. The more you fucking do it, the more you lose.
Great. I was gonna say, the more you're a fool. Because I was expecting to fucking live.
No,
you fucking motherfucker! Seriously, that is why bosses don't final spin on the spot. So you have more room to fucking maneuver.
But no, we're not gonna do that with Raymond, we're gonna have him fucking spin and face you every second.
Oh my, are you kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh no. I love all your attacks that have delays. They're so good because it's just I've
love them so much I want to marry and fuck them.
Okay, Rame. I'm gonna have a heart to heart with you. Okay, cause this is what I do to make myself feel better.
You were the brother of Velstarit.
Be that brother in arms or actual blood brother, I don't fucking know. It's up for interpret goddamnation, as is the rest of this fucking game.
As is up for the reasoning of why the fuck I decided to do this to myself today, because I don't have an answer. But anyway, yes, you were the brother of whatever form of Velstarit, and he embarrassed the balls off of you to the point where you fled the fucking kingdom to somewhere else entirely. Your balls were fucking severed, your tail was between your legs. I'm not fucked. Then you just wandered over to the Old Iron Kingdom, and the Old Iron Kingdom was dead, fucked, and blundered. And then you found an old woman made of ash and said, yeah, fuck it, you're my new fucking mother figure. My father figure fucked me over. I'm gonna trust you, an ashen idol. How'd that go for you? You sold your soul to a thing trapped in dust, and now you're just this eternal, horrible burden on anybody that pays 10 fucking quid. For this bloody DLC.
But in war interpretation, you're a burden on anybody that decides to try and plunder and reclaim the clowns.
Clowns? Okay then, I'm a fucking idiot. Oh my god, stop doing that attack. I'm begging you.
Well, actually, I'm not begging you. Like, I literally just dug into your history and insulted you and mocked you for bloody finding a mother figure.
One, in a shard of manis, and two, in something made of fucking dust. Like, seriously. Come to my room, look under the bed, dust bunnies for days, there's your fucking mother figure, bitch. Grow a fucking pair. Oh, just suck my dick. It is unclear what the actual effective range of that little fucking premature ejaculation bastard inhalation blast actually is.
I don't know if you can tell, I'm getting pretty fucking sick of this.
What's the lowest I've gone in his health to?
75%? Has it even been that?
Because I've been doing this for about 50 minutes.
You know, it'd be nice, Rhyme, if I could visit a memory of the king. And I could see you and Velstadter side by side. You know what I'd fucking do? I'd kill you. In the memory, so this never happened. Even though it's not the way memories work in Dranglake, you can't fucking go ahead. Ooh, and paradox yourself. You can't bloody space-time continue and Doctor Who the shit out of characters in memories, unfortunately. The memory is just a memory. It is an isolated fucking incident. Whatever you do in there does not, wow, affect anything living or dead. It's a goddamn shame, because I would love to just go back into a memory of the king, see you, and just tell you what's going to happen in the future, and say, hey, just be nice to Velstadter, whatever the fuck you fell out about, just don't do it. That way, maybe, well, fuck off, that way Vendrick might just live a little longer, and then Velstadter can have some company when he's just being all decrepit in the crypt. Yeah. That's grim, actually, now I think about it. Yes, that's pretty grim. I've depressed myself while already being miserable fighting a bloody boss. I just noticed that didn't stagger me. Oh, well, fuck my life. Just... The most damage I can do to you at one time ever is at the beginning when you're doing those animations, and anything after that I can get one hit on you and that's about it, unless I just want to get greedy and die. Oh. Hello! I'm dead, because you vinyl recorded on the spot, tracked and looked at me on your recovery animation for an attack. If I get hit by one thing and then get fucking clipped by your magical fucking limbo blade as you goddamn Disco Inferno spin on the fucking floor and spin around on the spot and... Fuck me. Oh my god. Just my god. And it just fucking vinyl record spins on the spot and doesn't give a shit about nobody. What the fuck happened there? God's sake. I can't deal with this. Who can? If you could be a big old doll and just like throw me a bone on a ball, that'd be great. Because you jumped at me at a specific fucking... Oh, just bury me! I don't give a shit. Might not be a lot of help, but I'm fucking healing. You are an absolute wanker. Oh, what the fuck? The ball had gone fucking through me! Yep, you predictable bitch. What the fuck? There's another attack after that? I have an itchy nose. It's fucking... Oh, there you go. Oh, that was even more important than fucking healing for me. Jesus Christ, that is satisfying. I get physical satisfaction. I already saw what I did wrong before it happened. And, yep. Oh, fuck me. Jesus Christ. Okay, I don't do this much in this series, but allow me to monologue on how fucking miserable I currently am. It's been an hour. I've gotten him to 75% health, as the high score milestone is something to supposedly brag about. And I wasn't even paying attention that time, so you know what, just fuck the monologue, it's fucking, it's done, it's dead and done and over, and I'm so fucking sick of this. This is probably the first one I'm ever just gonna full on quit and not even bother fucking killing the boss for, because if the best I can do is 75%, 75% for a 10-minute fight, then I don't actually want to win. I don't want to have a 40-minute fucking... God. Oh, my. Oh, fucking bollocking. His health was like 40%. That's the lowest it's ever been. And I just died because I didn't fucking roll through the fucking easiest fucking tack he fucking does. Whatever, though. So. Good fucking job. Just... Go and fuck yourself with your bullshit fucking swinging attacks that go 180 degrees from the opposite way you're fucking facing. I can't do this. This is fucking stupid and impossible. All of his attacks have delays. It's so good. Oh my fucking Christ on a bike! How the fuck? How did I even get you to like 40 fucking percent health? I can't even get you to fucking lose 14. Oh. This is impossible. Fucking great. Just brilliant. Just fucker, you fuck. I fucking healed twice and I've only got one. What the fuck? You cue my moves all the time. You don't fucking do it then. taking the fucking piss. Wow, I just died because of that! I seriously fucking quit, that's it now. I don't know how many hours it's been, but I give up. Fuck yourself, you horribly lonely wanker. That's great. Every boss should be designed with this instant recovery animation, because that way I can want to kill myself every time I fight a boss instead of just this one. Oh my god, why are you such a monotonous sack of dog shit? No, I can't even pretend to cheer myself up. This is fucking pathetic. What, I've been doing this for 2 hours. I'd quite like it if you rotted in fucking hell. I'd quite like it if you didn't immediately recover from your attacks. I'd quite like it if your recoveries were consistent. Fuck me, the tracking's inconsistent now. Oh my god, how I wish you would actually not have the health of a mountain. Just got to wait centuries for you to erode. That is literally what I have to do. Okay, yeah, that was 2 hours. That was 2 hours and a half of my life. 150 minutes, a lot of seconds, and not a lot of soul left. I can't celebrate in words. So, Oh, my fucking God. You know the beginning verse to 8 Mile from Eminem, you know, knees weak, arms are heavy, mom's... Yeah, that bollocks, yeah, pretty much went through that for the past fucking 2 hours. The whole knees weak and arms heavy bit, yeah, it's just been like the last 2 minutes, me just fucking shaking with my heart pounding through my chest. Yeah, good night, thanks, love. You. And that's the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching all the way through to the end. If you feel it deserves it and you actually enjoyed this series and would want to see more of it, then please do like the video. And if you should find yourself liking it to a greater extent, then feel free to subscribe and share this to your friends so they may do the same. And here's a hint you may not need, the soapboxes don't always do their job, so feel free to bookmark my video page or just follow me on social media, anyone will do. And now seeing as Destiny is finally released, feel free to join the clan so you can get in on the action a little bit easier than usual. Apparently it actually works better than it did in the beta. So yeah, thanks again for sticking around this long. I'd like to think that you're looking forward to future content, and if so, I will see you in the next video.